Hi, my name is Shelly Ann, and I work in the Windows Servicing and Delivery team at Microsoft. Welcome to the Windows 11 release notes for August 2023. Got a need for speed? Today, we'll show you how to reduce the time it takes to start using your device after a restart. We'll also show you how to get to apps, settings, and files more effectively. Before that, let's look at a few highlights from this month's update. First, this update makes brightness settings more accurate. For those who use Chinese characters in handwriting tools, these tools now meet level 3 requirements. If widgets on pins from the taskbar when you didn't expect it, we've addressed that issue for you. You might have noticed that certain display and audio devices are missing after your system resumes from sleep. This update addresses that issue. And finally, we've addressed a VPN performance issue. The issue affects those of you who use a wireless mesh network. Want to explore more from this update? See the highlights and improvements section of the July 2023 preview and the August 2023 security update articles. Now, on to our Windows tips. Tip number one, speed up at startup. Does your PC seem to take a lot of time to start or sign in? It might be time to investigate your startup apps. Some apps are set up to run when you sign in. In most cases, these apps start minimized or in the background. Customizing which apps run at startup in Windows 11 couldn't be easier. Go to Settings, Apps, Startup. Review the list and consider switching off any productivity apps that you don't need when you first sign into your device. We suggest that you choose the ones that are noted as high impact. You can still use these apps whenever you like. Switching the toggle to off simply means they won't automatically run when you first start your device. One important note. To ensure your device remains protected, don't turn off security or antivirus apps. This is especially vital if your employer provides your computer. Tip number two, get friendly with the Windows logo key. You can get to apps, files, and settings using the Start menu or File Explorer, but is a surprisingly simple way to get there faster. Meet your best friend on the keyboard, the Windows logo key. Simply press the Windows logo key and start typing. Let's say you want to open OneNote. Press the Windows logo key, and by the time you've typed O-N-E, Windows has suggested the OneNote app as the best match. All you have to do now is press the Enter key, and voila, you've opened OneNote. Finding a setting is just as easy. For example, want to increase the font size for text on your PC? Press the Windows logo key and type font size. Windows will recommend the setting to help you make text size bigger. You'll also see a list of related settings, such as handwriting font size, caption styles, and visual effects. The same approach works when searching for files stored on your local PC or OneDrive, if you're signed in. And of course, you can use the Windows logo key for a variety of keyboard shortcuts. These include displaying or hiding the desktop or toggling the mute button for your microphone. Using voice recognition instead of the keyboard? No problem. Simply say Start menu instead of pressing the Windows logo key to search for files, apps, and settings. Or say Windows logo key plus to use keyboard shortcuts. Are there Windows 11 features you'd like to know more about? Send us your feedback in the section provided in this article. You can also leave us a comment on our Windows Community YouTube channel at aka.ms/Windows Community on YouTube. That's it for this month. Thanks for watching.